Hello, this is Fernando coming to you from beautiful Melbourne with your 60 seconds of motivation, inspiration, tips and resources to help you grow your home business. Today I'm talking about beliefs and maybe a little bit of a challenge, right? So what beliefs do you have and could they be holding you back from achieving the results that you want in your life? Maybe better health, better happiness and more wealth. Now, beliefs is something that's really interesting because beliefs are typically programmed in us from a very young age. And typically, they are not even your own beliefs. They are the beliefs of your parents. They are the beliefs of your teachers. They are beliefs of the people of influence around you. And unfortunately, most people never really stop to challenge those beliefs and whether they're helping them achieve better results. All we know is we're producing X type of results today, but a lot of people don't actually stop to think about, well, where do they come from? Are they serving me? And should I be challenging those beliefs? And the best way that I can explain it is if you just imagine that your body is a vehicle, okay? And let's say that your body is a Lamborghini, okay? It's a beautiful car, a lot of power, a lot of potential, right? But imagine if you had a cruise control in that car that only allows it to operate at a maximum of 60 kilometers per hour or 60 miles, right, if you're on the other side of the world. So here, this beautiful vehicle that has huge potential, can go very fast, you can experience exhilaration of that speed, right, but you're only ever going to be capped at 60 kilometers per hour, and you didn't even know, right, that it's capped. All you know is, this is the result that I produce, right? And so I want to challenge you today to take a minute and just examine the different parts of your life, your business results, your health, your happiness, your relationships, and ask yourself, what do I believe about these different areas of my life? And are those beliefs serving me? And, you know, some of these beliefs come from religion, right? So religious beliefs is probably a big one. It was a big one for me. And I think, you know, you really would do yourself a favor to stop and think, are your religious beliefs, I'm not talking about spiritual beliefs, I'm not talking about God beliefs. There's a difference between having a relationship with God, if you're a Christian person, or having religious beliefs. That's what I'm talking about. Because they create feelings of guilt, they create feelings of fear, right? And it's these feelings of guilt and fear that are typically going to hold a lot of people back. Hey Ed, thanks for joining. And Jose, thanks for joining here. So just talking about beliefs and that can, and how they could be impacting the results that we are producing in our life. This is an area that I'm really passionate about because I know for a long time I was held back because of these beliefs. Not taking action, not pursuing certain things. I mean, money is a big one. You know, money is a big paradigm. So beliefs are really, when you think about beliefs, they're stored in the innermost part of you, which is your subconscious mind. They become conditioning, a fixed way of operating without conscious thought. And that's why it's called the paradigm, right? And Bob Proctor talks about paradigms and how to shift those paradigms. In fact, he was doing a seminar on that over the weekend. It's paradigm shift. How do we do that? Now, the sad part, this is the sad part for me as a coach, as someone that helps a lot of people, is to watch people operate from an old belief system that doesn't support them and never really stop to think about, well, are they serving me and how do I shift them? Now, before we can even consider shifting these beliefs, we need to understand how they're formed. And before we can understand how they're formed, we need to understand what part of our mind they're formed in and how does it operate. Because we cannot change a belief if we don't know, first of all, how it got there, and secondly, how do we put a new one, okay? And so I want to invite you to click on the link above that I've just shared here. There's a program that I've done with Bob Proctor that I've facilitated. Is a member of his group, whatever you want to call it. I've invested a lot of time, many years, learning from Bob, who's been my teacher, my mentor, on how to actually understand our mind so that we can actually begin to make the mental shifts necessary. And you owe it to yourself, and you owe it to your family, and you owe it to the people that you're trying to serve to actually operate from the best version of you. It's allowing that true potential that is inside of you. You know, like that Lamborghini has its huge potential to go fast, But we got to take the cruise control off. We just got to remove it and just see what's really there and how fast it can go and really experience that. But you're never going to do that if you don't understand how your mind works and how to program a new belief that's going to maybe serve you a lot better than what your beliefs are serving you today. And if you're not sure what this all means, I would just invite you to look at the different areas of your life. Look at the results that you're producing. It's always good to go to the result if you're not sure about something and say, well, am I happy with that result? If I'm not, then why am I producing that result? And maybe that'll give you some insight as to what it is. Ask yourself, what do I believe about money? What do I believe about people? What do I believe about relationships? What do I believe about wealth and health and all these things? And then you can start to really assess what beliefs you may have, and then you can make some decisions about, is it something that you want to change, alter, or improve? You may be quite happy with the results that you're producing. You might be happy with the beliefs that you have because they may be serving you. I'm not saying that everybody's beliefs don't serve them. You may have already done a lot of work in that area and achieving those results. But if you're not, if you know that there's more to life, if you know that there's a better life to be lived, if you know that there's a lot more that you could be achieving for yourself, for your family, then I want to invite you to just consider this part of you and challenge those beliefs. I began challenging my beliefs about a year ago to really look at, are they serving me? More so religious beliefs, are they serving me? And just ask the question, look at every part of your life, right? Look at every part of your life. And if they're not, then it's time to take action. It's time to leave that your full potential. It's time to allow that best version that is programmed, that perfection that is inside of you, to come out and live that fully expressed, authentic life that's going to allow you to impact thousands of people. If you're in the network marketing industry, if you're in business, if you want to work with others, you can only do that by working on yourself and allowing that best version of you come out so that you can touch lives. So there's my message for you this morning. It's a glorious morning here in Melbourne. You see the sun's about to come out. Glorious day. It's very early, still very cold in Melbourne, Australia. I hope this message makes a difference for you. And if it did, do me a favor and comment below what you think about what I'm sharing. Does it make sense for you? And share it with someone that you know, maybe even someone in your team that you know has so much potential, but may be limited by their thinking, which is really it's a symptom of those beliefs that they may have and how they can start to change that. Okay, so have a blessed day. Thanks for joining in, for those of you that have joined me live. And if you're watching the recording, then leave me a comment. Let me know how I can continue to serve you. Also, head over to my blog where I have a free gift for you, 10 ways, 10 days to more leads, more prospects, and more cash flow to help you grow your business. All right, take care. Be blessed. Bye for now.